Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It is grand final day here at the home of football, North Hobart, as we see the Southern Storm, the boys from the South who are up against the might of the undefeated Tigers here in the under 18. It is the Colts grand final in the SFL.
Yes, mate, I just about got run over by a bunch of Southern Storm boys. By crikey, they are pumped. And this ground, Hobby, is in fantastic condition.
Have a look at these young fellas. They've been moulded very nicely by super coach William Perry.
Both sides, initially, they've really seemed to have picked up their aggression. I think the frustration, they're starting to vent it out there as we see the ball coming forward yet again for the Southern Storm. But I'll throw it back to you, Hoppy. But yet again, Hobart have cleared it. So what a game.
Thank you very much, Guy. And I tell you what, Leon, I reckon that's a frustrated commentator down there on the boundary line.
Oh,
we're asking for a quick comment, and he just will not be quiet as that ball comes back in towards the centre of the ground. And a great mark there by the Tigers. Gee, that was good work. Turn around and trying to get the ball moving. Nice open forward line. Gunning back. A courageous mark taken by Andrew Arthur. Gee whiz, that was good play. Have a look at this mark. He had no idea who was coming.
Courtesy of
Bennett Petroleum replay there. Taking that mark. But now it is most important, Leon, that he goes back and slots the goal.
Absolutely, Hoppy. Now, look, they're both goalless. I've not been to a grand final before where neither side scored a goal at quarter time. So there's still no goal kicked. So this
it
is extraordinary circumstances.
Big, strong mark taken there. Gee whiz, that was good work. I think that might be Hovington.
Yeah, they're full forward. He's kicked a lot of goals this year. In fact, I think he's won the leading goal kicker for the competition. I'm not sure quite how many, but yeah, very good player.
He is a good player. He's looked likely, but they need to give him some space. And it is Hovington now. Just settling down. No doubt about it, the best opportunity to kick that goal. And he has done. He's got him up and about.
Darren, Matty Brereton was very, very animated there. He's calling on his players to hit their targets and get their composure. How's Will?
Yeah, look, he's pretty composed. Like it was a typical scrappy start to a grand final, but the boys are up. They're trying their best, and we just hope that when it opens up that we use the ball a little bit better.
Good luck, mate. Well, you're lucky to have that goal on the ball. You'd be very happy. Okay, back to you in the central commentary position, Hobby.
Yeah, thanks very much, Guy, down on the boundary.
I don't know if he's injured or what the situation is, or he's just got a station forward role, but yeah, I haven't seen him much in the middle.
Okay, so Brereton was paid the free kick. He was dealt with off the ball. And so there we can see it was Gardner who went in. And he doesn't get the ball, but he's a big chance going down towards the full forward. And they gave him a little bit of space. And I tell you what, I really like the way Hovington took that mark. You could see what he tried to do. We can see here on the Bennett's Petroleum replay. He was he actually guarded that area, and he kept his defender away from the ball. So he took a really nice mark, and he is going to come in. Here's our goal kicker as he's lining up. You can see here what he's got in front of him. He kicks.
He's missed that. Wow.
Has he missed it?
Oh. No.
In she goes yet again. And they've got the numbers of Tigers. Be careful, son, as he tries to get round one and another. A quick handball comes out. It is Coulson who picks it up. Coulson spins that back around. End over end. Look at the vagaries of this. Oval ball. Holy dolly. Merrily, Darren would have been proud of that one as the Jedi Warrior Ord picks that one up and he clears it. Talk about millimetres.
Oh, I think they had that one in the bank and had to bring it back out.
A quick withdrawal there from the Storm. And it is Georgie O'Neill. That is a really tough angle going close towards the line.
Wow.
And they are millimetres away from two sausage rolls.
Would have put Stephen Milne in the shade, that one. It really did turn at right angles.
All right, so here come the Storm. They're brim with confidence. They know that while they have this momentum swing, they have to score. They have to put scoreboard pressure on the Tigers. Well, that was Gaelic footy style as Hobart tried to pick that one up. It is picked out of the square.
Oh, great goal. It's a really good goal.
And the Storm have put that one through. Oh, I know back when I played the Sunday comp against Ridsenvale and Big Bert Woods came out. This was down under 13s and he had the biggest beard ever known to man. Mm. And I tell you what, it didn't make me jump too high. I'll give you the tip. And so Hobart pick it up and they're going back inside. It was Plummer who can't quite take the possession of the ball. They've got to hang on. That's a really good tackle. They are undersized, but I tell you what, they show great courage. Oh, the Storm. They were tackled that particular time and dropped it like a hot potato.
He didn't play advantage there. It's interesting.
Let's have a look. Was there advantage?
Oh, there was.
The goal kick?
Yeah, the guy, yeah. Now, that's advantage. The fact he didn't kick the goal is not Southern Storm's problem. That was advantage, and he paid it. Had a good season, Mark Cripps. Compliments Lochie Plumber beautifully.
Here he goes. Just taking his time. A little bit of a breather. Just getting his composure over the ball. Here we go. We can see a nice clean drop. And I tell you what, I think he has put that one through. And it's all but like this is exactly the same thing that happened in first quarter and the second quarter. Hobart start the better. And he's got that there. He's holding the ball dead set. Dropped it like a hot spud. And a lovely tackle by Russell. Russell going that short kick. Bit of open space down right underneath the tower as Code goes back, goes onto his trusted left boot, down towards half forward line. Oh dear, oh dear. This has absolutely killed the Storm, Leon.
Oh, the drop marks
they've come out. They've really created space and they've dropped the onion at the last minute. The Tigers now through a succession of handballs. They're nice and open towards that forward flank. It was Oprah who goes and gets the ball. Have a look at this play by Anderson. A quick handball over the top. The goal kicker in Cripps. Cripps is steady.
Very good goal.
And he has slotted through for a goal. Nice play by the Tigers.
Yeah, look, that's how Hobart have played all year. Just a chip and run handball. Three or four handballs, space, goal. So that's the Hobart that I've seen a bit of this year. And I think this is what I fear for Southern Storm. I think once Hobart gets some momentum up, some confidence up, they're just going to move the ball around just like they did there, and they're going to be very hard to stop.
He needs to really kick through this one, unlike last time.
Yeah, correct.
He comes, he certainly has.
He's drilled it.
Oh, and Plummer. He's put a dagger in the heart of the Storm, and he's put that one through for a goal right in the thick of it, and he's getting his hands on the ball.
Yeah,
early.
Gardner started in the middle early in the game, and then they took him out, I guess, to try and preserve him a bit, but he certainly has started in the middle in this quarter and has been instrumental in getting the contested ball.
Well, talking of marks, that was Colson, who has, let's be blunt, this young man has had the fumbles early on, but he took a very strong mark on that one. He's played on, and he has drilled that one through. So we saw a shot from the Peter Sharp Tower side, so we're back now on the Harry Ward side as that kick comes in. It's a drop punt going close towards the goal. That is a kick.
That's what they needed.
We've come a long way, okay? Think about that. When it gets tough, think about how tough it was last year, okay? When you get tired, think about how tired we would have been last year chasing us, okay? We've got a chance to make some terrific history for this footy club right now.
Oh, look, I could feel the hairs coming up, what hair I have on the back of my neck there. He really did inform those players to create history for this football club. You heard it there, guys, and you get the feeling they're going to really lift and push this last quarter. So it's still up for grabs. You know, Southern Storm, they're up and about, they're excited, they feel they're a chance. So it's going to be a great, great game. So we're looking forward to this final quarter.
It was in that last stages of the quarter that the Storm really came back hard with those couple of goals to Jakey Munnings. Now they pick it up to the Tigers, but a good smothering in defence for the Storm. They still have the footy now. Nice handball over. They're going towards their full forward. It might have been Plummer.
He just put his
arm out and owned that area and took a great mark, as we see there on replay, courtesy of the Bennett's Petroleum. It's the Tigers. Would really love this one. The drop punt.
Oh, his arm's up. He's excited.
That is why Lochie Plummer has been named the best player throughout the regular season, because he gets clutch goals when they need them.
That's kind of been like that for each quarter. Storm really need to get inside their forward 50 a lot earlier than they have. And they're under pressure now. They need a goal.
Have a look at that.
That
kick.
Is a
it's
big
gone
kick.
From fullback almost out towards the centre of the ground.
That's 60-odd metres, that. That's a big kick.
Oh, Cripps has gone down. What's he got, the cramp? He is in all sorts of pain. He said, "For Gordon Bennett, can someone help me?" So he is dead set down on the ground.
I'd say it's more than cramp.
Okay, Plummer picks it up. He gets the handball across to Hovington. And he's drilled that one through. Tremendous work. They have got the goal. Maybe was it Hovington who got that? We're going to have a look on the Bennett's Petroleum.
Well, I'm keeping an eye on young Cripps. He looks in trouble.
Yeah, you keep an eye on that. And it was Sebastian Godfrey, my apologies, who put that one through. And I'll tell you what, didn't he give the fits the two bearded boys
there? He did. He enjoyed that.
kicking it back in towards the danger area. They've got the big players there and they can afford that sort of entry, I guess, Leon. Not with any great system, but they know they've got the big men then that had the potential to clunk it. They've got the front and centres now, back inboard, a bit of a push, driving it towards the goal. And it is through.
Stop the fight, Terry Riley.
Goal, as we'll just check on the Bennett Petroleum replay, who was our goal kicker there, but they are a very, very happy team, it appears now.
Well, they've actually doubled Storm's score now. You wouldn't have thought that 10 minutes ago, but it's 27-point lead to Hobart, and they've really dominated this quarter. They've gone inside nine times.
Anyway, it is the Storm now with 3.5 minutes left. Jake Munnings, who we know kicks a goal. He's got two already. Nice-looking drop punt. I think it's going to drop short. Oh, there is the mark that we required. That's an excellent mark. It is an excellent
contested
mark. So Will Polly, who's got a good vertical leap, lovely effort, and he has slotted that one through for the Storm.
It's all academic, but yeah, that'll certainly give them a little bit of confidence, but they can't, well, they're 20 points down, they can't win this game, I wouldn't have thought.
And it's been a really interesting and good quality game of SFL Colts in the grand final here at the North Hobart Oval. It is the Hobart Tigers versus the Southern Storm, coming to you live from Duff TV here at the home of football. Another free kick by the Tigers. Inside their 50, deep as the arms go up. And gee whiz, Hovington. Marcus Coulson lining up for goal. Coulson taking his time. And he has put that one through for goal. Well done, young man, Marcus Coulson. He's been a good player for the Storm. And that is his second, and great to hear all the fans from the Storm urging them on.
As all over. That, what a fantastic game of football.
Siren. The siren has gone, and it is a victory for the Tigers. As we can see here, the coach, Will Perry, is absolutely cock-a-hoop.
It was a really hard game. Signet came to play early, and as I knew they would, and we all knew they would, and it was on for the entire game. And we were just lucky to get over the line in the end, but yeah, really good effort by all the boys.
Magnificent effort, Phil. We'll go get out there and you celebrate with the boys.
Cheers, mate.
Congratulations.
Cheers, mate.
Well done.
Well, it's very good scenes now here, and this is what you do like to see in footy, Leon. The players go out, they play it hard, they play it tough, and here they are, the combatants, just looking at each other in line and saying congratulations and bad luck, and that's what sport's all about.
Yeah, certainly, Hoppy. It was a very willing game, very physical game, but there was no spite that I detected, and I think these sides respect each other. Hobart certainly respects Storm and the improvement they've made over the course of the season, and of course Storm would take their hats off to Hobart.
Firstly, congratulations to the Hobart Footy Club and Will Perry. You've obviously been the form side all year, haven't lost a game, and you're the better side again today, unfortunately for us. Look, we just never gave up all day. We've had a pretty tough year, I suppose. Low numbers, a lot of part of the year, and we've done really well to get here today, I think. We can hold our heads high. We had a fair old crack at it. It was never out of the game. But unfortunately, boys, today we just couldn't find a winner up forward. So well done to Hobart.
Firstly, I'd like to say thanks to the Hobart Football Club for giving me the opportunity to coach. It was obviously a little bit of a punt to take with me at such a young age and being so close in terms of age to the young boys here. But looks as though it's paid off, I guess. And I hope that myself and the boys have done you guys proud. To our guys, we turned it on today, didn't we? Okay, we got it done. That's what we wanted to do. Coming from last year, obviously not being able to win a game all year, and coming this year, it's just been a real Cinderella story, and I'm really humble and happy to have been a part of it and to have hopefully helped in some way. So thank you.
I'll now ask Tony Gibson to present the Premiership Cup to the Premiership winning coach and Premiership winning captain, Will Perry and Jaden Marshall. Ladies and gentlemen, your premiers for 2017 in the SFL Colts, the Hobart Tigers.
Well, there it is. It is scenes of jubilation down there at North Hobart Oval.
Hobart forever! Yeah.